Okay, penultimate level, not including the boss fight. And it's a pretty big level. As you saw if you were watching the previous video, easily big enough to literally swallow the container, the aircraft carrier hole. So this thing's an absolute beast. Now the problem that you face when you have this level here right at the start is as soon as you climb up to the second level here, this hatch opens and before you realize it the submarine's going to start diving, so you're gonna have to make a break for it to the left here, and if you're just quick enough you should be able to get in before the water level rises, because if you hesitate for I would say even maybe a few seconds then you're probably going to run out of time. But as soon as you jump down here it automatically seals itself, which is nice, and then you can get started with finding the tokens. Totally 4 in this first area here, and then we move into this conference room looking area here where we have another 5 tokens next to these chairs here. Some more ammo and a Rico telepoint that will come in handy later. But just like the previous level, as soon as you try to move through, you get another message. Away,
we can set course for Furfighter Village. Once there, I intend to release a full-scale atomic missile strike against your precious village. This impressive submarine is invulnerable to all forms of attack. In fact, the only thing that could damage it would be itself.
Which begs the question, if he's so confident about his submarine, why doesn't he just launch the missiles now? Surely he can't be that far away from Furfighter Village, but I suppose he knows best. But I would say if he really wanted to go about taking out the Furfighters, he should probably think about doing it a little bit more quickly, seeing as how we're obviously going to have to destroy this submarine here, and he's just given us the hint that we have to use the own weapons on board this submarine in order to do it. But a little bit more about that later. For the moment, another 4 tokens in this locker room here, and another bear on the other side here, and then a few more enemies, just try and trigger them without getting caught in the middle of it all. And then as soon as you step out onto this platform here again, another little ambush thing that you have to take care of. But apart from that, you can obviously hear the lobsters are in the water far underneath, but we're not going to go in there just yet. But as you can see here, the full scale of the aircraft carrier that we were just on, and this submarine is easily containing it with loads of space on either side, just to give a sense of the scale that we're dealing with here. But anyway, you don't need another lesson in that, I suppose. To begin with, what I will do, in addition to crocodiles at every other endpoint here, there's also a token, so it's pretty much token to begin with, and then crocodile, and then a few tokens at the back here, and a few more crocodiles at the other side. 17, and another panda bear at the back here. And just take care of these enemies here. That's us. So you're kind of left, if you've never played this level before, you've kind of got some options. If you go through there, then you'll proceed through the rest of the level and there's a part that you have to do in order to get what we're aiming for. If you go into this room here, however, down this, what I'm going to call the, second missile room, and it'll become obvious why. If you come in here, then this is the weapon that we're going to be using. I call it the missile room. It's probably closer to torpedo room, but like this torpedo here is what we're going to be using to destroy this submarine. However, whenever you go to try and launch it, of course it wouldn't be that simple. We need some launch codes, and it just so happens that in order to get the launch codes, we need both the captain's key and the first mate's key. And obviously it would be nice if they're like were directly next to each other, but it just ain't that simple again. So we're going to have to find both of those keys before we can unlock the safe that contains those codes, and then once we have those codes we can come back to that room, launch the torpedo, and then that will be it done. So what I'm going to do first is through this room here, which will be the first torpedo room. And once you've taken care of the three bears that are inside, you get this little chap coming out here. Why there is a beaver aboard this submarine, I have absolutely no idea. However, he does point out an interesting thing, I suppose, for lack of a better term. The reason why, I should probably point this out, the reason that you don't want to transform into Rico as soon as you see him is that, yes, it is useful for getting the tokens that are underneath the carrier. However, the part that's about to come up here, unfortunately we're going to have to launch ourselves out of this torpedo tube. There's just no other way around it. It does come in useful. We need it in order to get to a key. And I'll be showing you why later on, but for the moment you just need to know that we will have to go out here. The reason that I don't transform into Rico right at the start is because if you die, then not only do you have to like run like all, like you're having to run all the way through that locker in the conference room area, and then fight all of those enemies again and then come down here, whereas if you just leave it as it is and you transform here and you die in the next part that's coming up ahead, it's obviously a far shorter journey to travel. So as soon as you get launched out here, the most important thing to realize or to know is that you have very little control over Rico. You're being like launched out at such a high speed that you barely move from like side to side with like the R2 and L2 buttons. You don't really have that much control. Thankfully, you don't really have to have that much control. There's only really one thing, which is that mine there that you have to swim out of the way for, out of. And then as soon as you like smack your head into that little piece of metal that's like jutting down, that's you pretty much done. If you obviously miss that piece of metal, then you're going to get grounded up into Diced Penguin in this case, which is quite a horrible thought, especially for Rico, but that's very unlikely to happen. As long as you stick to the center path and you just avoid that missile, if you avoid that depth charge that's just lurking around there, then you shouldn't really have too many problems. But again, another four tokens in this area here, and then as soon as you dive down you get transported into here, and then we have another bunch of tokens at the bottom here along with some health if you took quite a bit of damage. I should also point out as well, just for the sake of completeness I suppose, that if you somehow even just touch those like rotating blades that you saw earlier, just a glancing blow against them or just like barely touching them will cause you to take a severe amount of damage, and it's more likely than not that you're probably going to die as a result of it, because you won't be able to get out of the way in time, so you'll just keep taking damage very, very quickly and then, you know, die as a result. But again, like I was saying, if you transform, or if you leave the transformation until you like end up in, I'm actually going to use that health now. But if you leave the like the transformation until you're actually inside the torpedo tube launch bay itself, then it'll obviously be a far lesser distance to travel. Almost, but no cigar. So, another 3 tokens here. And then we make our way up through here. In fact, what I'm going to do, now that I think about it, there's a Chang telepoint on the other side here. We don't especially need Chang for anything that's coming up. However, there is another forced quasi quick time event that's coming up, and if you fail that, then you have to go through that entire torpedo launching sequence again as Rico. And since I kind of want to avoid that, since there's not 100% guarantee I'm actually going to do this next part correctly, I'll just transform it into Chang and make it a bit easier on me. Also, it saves less editing that, you know, that I have to do. Anyway, we have a steering console up here, and this is primarily the reason why you have to dive, or like you have to be launched out of the torpedo tube and then like come in from another point. It's basically on the other side of this glass door, bulkway, whatever you want to call it, partition thing. There's another one like just behind this key here, and that is permanently locked. You can't get into that until you solve the puzzle that's on this side here. So if you were to go back like all the way around that gangway area near the carrier and exit on the very last door, you would eventually battle your way through, and I'll be getting to it shortly, but you would battle your way through like a certain area and you would come to that door on the other side, and you'd be pretty much stuck. So you'd have to come all the way back around here and then obviously, you know, launch yourself out the torpedo tube as Rico. But I've went and done that first. So the thing to know, to like basically to get it to trigger, you'd probably discover it accidentally if you were to like try and like escape here. It would be detected, and then you just have to quickly get over to the actual console itself. Now, for me personally, I have never really died because of a depth charge. It's always because I've never been able to like navigate around this area. Like, I've always went too quick and the steering's always been too sluggish to respond. But obviously, just like driving a real car, it's far easier. It's far easier to navigate corners if you take it nice and slow. If you're going at like full speed, then it's obviously going to be much harder to get through. But for the most part, you should have plenty of time to react to the depth charges that are falling. But again, for me personally, I find the environment to be more challenging to navigate. But again, that's just me. You might have a different experience. And then as soon as you see this little red, or not little, but this massive red cave part here, obviously the submarine takes control of itself again. Not entirely sure why it couldn't have dodged it itself, but oh well, I guess they had to put in a puzzle somewhere. But by doing that, we unlock this door to get the first mate's key. And since we obviously can't swim back the way to get back into the torpedo tube, we're kind of forced to come through here. Just take care of these guys here. Pick up a bit more ammo, so now at this point, just come in here, take care of these bears, because there's a few hidden tokens, not a lot of them obviously, but just a few hidden here. Cool. So if you go through this door and then exit down here, you'll be presented with another like ambush room with quite a lot of bears to take care of. Again, more tokens on these tables here. With some inspirational posters, to say the least. And then this takes you into this room through that door there, and I'll probably just back out just in case I get shot to pieces, but behind that door that I was pointing out in the upper area there, that's what you would eventually go through had you entered the last door after making your way all the way around the carrier. What I'm going to do though is make my way back out to where the carrier's positioned itself, since I want to get the tokens that are underneath the carrier before going any further. Oops, I was going to get squashed there for some reason. Let's bring it back down here. And as soon as you rise up here, you have a ambush waiting for you on both ends, regardless of what way you go down. And it's always on the opposite end. So you can come through here, and then by going up into this upper area here, and this takes you to ultimately where you want to go to. But again, more invisible dragon lizard things to take care of. Let's take care of them. So this safe is what we're aiming for, and since we have the first key, or the first mate's key I should say, that completes one half. We still have to find the captain's key. I think I'll collect those tokens later since we'll be coming back here. Once we have the captain's key anyway. So this brings us back out here in a somewhat better position. Although I think what I've done is kind of went round in a complete circle, obviously. So I think just to get my bearings straight, what I'm going to do is just make it back to the actual room that contains the carrier itself, and then I'll come back through here and do it in a somewhat more logical manner, but we should be there already, yeah. So yeah, I think what I'm going to do, yeah, I will make my way all the way around this part here. And then once I have done that, I will transform into Rico and then proceed to get the tokens that are underneath the water, along with the lobsters obviously, but not much I can do about that, I'm afraid. Hopefully I should be able to make it up here without dying though. One thing that I will say about the gangway area is that it's very bad for respawning enemies when they technically shouldn't, once you've already killed them, that is. But you might have seen just outside the first missile room, or the missile room, the first torpedo room, as soon as you kill the bears, and as I'm demonstrating here, they just keep respawning, which is rather annoying, but there's not an awful lot to do you can do about it, unfortunately. Likewise with these torpedoes, now you should technically be fast enough to just avoid their attacks all the time, but I suppose to be safer rather than sorry, you might want to take them out. The unfortunate thing of course is that it's quite hard to get an angle with regards to like shooting them directly. Grenades can be done, but they tend to like be a bit inaccurate, so I think the only thing to really do is to just take the plunge and then hope that you're outside of their like field of view. Um, but in total you're looking for 12 tokens that are dotted around this outside perimeter here. Yeah, they've already caught up with me. The good thing, of course, is that there's quite a bit of a delay, like as with like previous levels, if you've seen them there as well. There's quite a bit of a delay when they actually stop to attack you and then when they actually proceed to attack you. So as long as you keep moving forward, you should be able to dodge there. You know, you shouldn't really take any much that much damage anyway. The good thing with collecting the tokens right at the bottom here is that it allows you to finish right next to this ladder here. And then you can quickly dive out, saves you having to do like another half lap of this submarine. Cool, so all the tokens have been collected over there and they've been collected in the first missile room, the first torpedo room and the second torpedo room. So now I'll proceed to go back through the rest of the level like I probably should have done a bit earlier. And then make a break through here. The steam does usually come out of these pipes here, as you saw me having to dodge earlier. I might have deactivated them by running through it though, but it's hard to say. That guy just got decapitated by that door. So, next thing to do is to collect the tokens that are underneath these missiles here. But first I'll take care of the bears that are here. And I count 9 missiles in total. There's 5 in this first part here. One under each missile, and then when you climb up here, pretty much on the opposite side of the room, directly in front, these ones here. There's one underneath each of those as well, and there's only 4 on this side, so that brings a total of 9. There are a few more tokens, however. There's a total of 2 that are underneath the staircases. There's one underneath this one. And then there should be one under here. Let's double around and take care of this guy. Again, I think there's no reason to play as Rico, and I'm kind of running low on health and I don't know where the health part packs are for this part. So I'm just going to transform into Bungalow, since if I die then I'll be relatively close to where I need to be anyway. So I'll just transform into him and then make my way up here and get another 2 tokens at the top. And there's the ones that I deliberately missed earlier. Then another 2 next to this periscope. And then when you come through here, just a case of falling down this ladder here. So this is the way to obtain the second key, which is right through there, but obviously it wouldn't be for fighters if we didn't have a, you know, puzzle to deal with. So this is the quick time event that I was talking about. Albeit a fairly simple quick time event. Now, of course, I mean, as you're seeing with like the flashing light and the buzzer like repeating more and more quickly, you don't have an awful lot of time. Like, it'll go through its usual green, red, but then as soon as it goes green, obviously it hits its alarm here. But as you can see, like, the alarm is going more and more quickly as time proceeds, so you want to make sure that you try and get it done as quickly as possible, since I haven't failed a quick time event by doing this, like, in practicing this level. However, I would have to assume that if you don't get it right the first time, then you've got quite a lot of, you know, you've not got that much time to repeat it. And if I remember correctly, this should be the last time that it does it.
Proximity alert over. Area is clear.
And again, with video game logic, it does beg the question, why not just go straight up? Like, why dodge all of these caverns? Like, why not just rise up to the surface, get out of the way, and then, like, go back underground? I mean, you kind of have to assume that within this world, like, there's pretty much only Viggo, and then there's the fur fighters in, like, the general ocean area. I can't really imagine that there's that many other animals out at sea trying to, you know, sail along or anything like that. But again, I'm reading too much into it. So with that done, you can now make your way back up here, or down, I should say. Again, just to show this is where I was before, completely going the wrong way. Then it's through this door here, and then down the way. It takes us into here. So the only thing remaining to do at this point is to insert the key into the safe, which I will just do now. And much like GoldenEye, if you've seen that film, if you hit any of these buttons, if you hit either key and then immediately try and go to run over and hit the other key, it'll flash from green to red. So the way to get around it, as I'll let Bristol explain here.
You feeling all right there, mate?
I would have liked to have seen. It's a bit of a shame that Bungalow always answers with, like, you know, his usual idiotic self. I would have preferred to have seen Rufus's response to that, or, you know, Juliet's or whatever. But again, like I was saying, much like GoldenEye, you have to have both keys turned at the same time in order to activate it. And it just so happens that whatever fur fighter you're playing has an impeccable shot of shooting a key from across the room. And as soon as you back yourself into one key, you just instantly want to shoot and then activate the next one that's across the room. And then by doing that, that allows us access to the torpedo launch codes. And with any luck, the remaining 9 tokens that I require for this level should be located in the second torpedo room. So the only thing left to do at this point is to now make my way all the way back there, put the launch codes in, and then Launch the missile. Excellent. Beep.
So, you've disabled my little submarine. No matter, it has served its purpose. I have you where I want you, and I shall be arriving momentarily to deal with you personally. Be seeing you.
Not entirely sure how it's still steering without its rudder, but wow, I totally want my own secret island. Holy crap. I think it was even like floating as well, because, like, you know, it like dumped itself into the ocean. How cool would that be though? Wow. But yeah, it's like 31 minutes. It's easily, I'm not trying to like oversell this or anything, but it's easily, if you know what you're doing and you get around it quickly, the V-100, like the submarine's easily the quickest level that isn't a boss fight within this game. Partly because the tokens are not like, I mean, they're strewn all over the place just with, you know, like any other level, but, you know, they're not hidden in like weird obscure places for the most part. Plus it helps that you don't have to collect a certain number of babies. But yeah, nice quick level. Which I suppose makes a change from the hour-long videos that you're probably used to at this point. But yeah, that's pretty much this done. So like I was saying, penultimate level that doesn't include the final boss fight, and I'm pretty sure you can guess what that is. So next time, I will basically just be finishing up, more or less, by... what do you call it? Completing the secret island that has now presented itself. So until next time, see you then.